like construction might get in earnest now. The renters are moving out, and they can really start to work on their building. They're working on the north side of the house, trying to see what they got in there. Looks like they're going to be finding some more logs or something. And note that they've probably got some more of the green stuff off the top in the front of the house, and now they're working on the side next to us, tearing some of the white weatherboarding off to get into the log. With the movers, if the renter's about gone, they'll probably make some really good progress now. But there's some logs there, and then back behind us, weatherboarding, and they got some more logs in there. Mr. Nichols says that's where the flue is located. Well, the crews arrived. They're really wreaking havoc on this place now. Didn't know they'd be so fast. I think the guy downstairs is going to get a little bit wet. Being exposed up on the top there. Those handsome workers and just tearing into everything. And the second floor hornet's nest. This was the smaller of the two. The lights were on to get the shot of the other one.
You're talking about something.
The second floor. Look at those rafters. They still have the bark on them. Fighting the light over on that side. Panning around the top floor. You've got everything right down to bare logs in the back and the front now. Second floor on the west side. On the east side, out toward the street now. That's where they're working today, getting all that stuff under, uncovering the logs and everything. The morning of July, June 4th, I thought I'd get a record of what it looks like after the work that they did on it yesterday. Now the north end of the house and the east end of the house. There's an exterior picture of the hornet's nest. I have a picture, took pictures yesterday inside the house. Boy, that's a big old hornet's nest. Up over the roof, you see the taking the windows off the front of the house. The other hornet's nest, and above, just above the window, you pan over here, and there's the one I just took pictures of. Here's the south side of the house. You see that they're just jerking that stuff off the wall. Here's the front bedroom. Zoom in there, and you can see what they're doing up there. This side of the house will just be bulldozed down. Actually, they use an end loader just to tear it down, not actually take the windows and stuff out of it. John, you note that the pump is partially off the cistern hole. When they start bulldozing around here, I may see if Ed Rock will just let me take the pump out of the way so it doesn't get damaged. I just looked at that pump a little bit. Actually, it's still got the pipe going down in the cistern. I'll probably, if Ed Rock will let me do it, I'll probably have to get Mr. Nichols to use his end loader to pick the pump up out of there so it doesn't get damaged as he works around this side of the house. Here goes the roof. They're taking her off there. Wednesday afternoon. Close up of the other hornet's nest. How'd you like to have those rung after you? Here's the nest up in the corner. Well, here's that big hornet's nest we've been talking about. It's almost as big as the guy. And down here, we got the other one somewhere.
I'll bring it on there.
Yeah. How'd you like those to get after you in a hurry? Left of the roof on the log house. He says that he's going to take it down tomorrow. There you see, they've got pictures of them pulling the chimney down. Zooming in on those logs that are used for rafters on the top roof. The roof is gone, the chimney's gone, and by this time tomorrow afternoon, about 4 o'clock, the log house will be gone. Looks like they're going to pull the staircase down now. Another try. Didn't get it down the first time. Gonna give another try at it. I believe they're gonna get it this time. There she goes. There she blows. There she blows. Of the north side of the house. Get that wood chinking in between the logs up there. Getting a new back door in the house now. Really ripping into it. It's about 4:15 on the 16th of June. Here's the way to take a house down in a hurry. stairwell was. They go up the stairs. Really wants to get all this stuff out of here so he can take the log sucker out. And just call Jim Nichols. He'll remodel it for you in a hurry. Going up to get the bathtub now. This might what you call an outdoor John, I don't know.
That thing got a metal right there.
Loose
from the floor, but it's got a fitting on it up front.
Either
hacksaw
or
what?
Got one?
In
the bed of his truck or in
that
pipe?
Yeah, now get that thing on out of there. What are you waiting for?
Watch out.
Put that karate chop on it.
I don't think I can break that.
Are you ready?
No. Might have to get bored or something
underneath
when you let the pressurize go.
There goes the old bathtub.
What do we have to do?
Out of your house. around 10 o'clock and they're getting the boom ready to start taking the house down. This is the west side, or the back side, whichever way you want to look at it. Looking in the window, you can see the logs on the south side of the house. Looking through what became the upstairs door of the apartment, you can see the logs from the inside on the front of the house. Here comes the rafters down. Off the top of the and get it pulled off. And now it's after lunch and they've got the chinking out of the top up there. Looks like they're about ready to remove the first log from the top of the north side. The gentleman with the white hair is the one that's the authority on restoring. Jim's up there hooking on to that first log now. Take it off the top in just a moment. Wave at me, Jim. Well, they picked her up and they're hollering about something. Log number one. Coming down. Down to the truck. Loading her on there. Where the ground crew is, there he comes. Or what is it? I don't know if it's a spike or what it is in the end of that log. Got to take one off the backside now for the second one now. comes number three off the top. No problem. Go ahead and yell.
I didn't want anybody hurt.
Yeah.
Looks like a crazy. Hey, Chris.
From the front side and the south side coming off with this load. Down onto the truck. Two more small ones coming out. Garbage on this and they have to take off before they load it on the truck. Another one going to the wagon from the north. Where the wind is, they think that log will probably break in two where the window's cut in, so they're nailing those boards to hope to get it off there in one piece. They got the same problem with this one. They got to nail some boards on it so it would stay together as where a window was upstairs. Hopefully they'll be successful. Put two straps around it and a cable between the straps to take it off that way. There we go. See if they have any luck on this one. Okay. Whoa, it's got two bad places in that one. Well, there came some more down. They didn't expect to come down. This mud was pretty good right in here. If they got to knock it out so they can get the chain around it to make their pickup.
Fix the mud to
come here? Yeah.
Another
case for one. Did it? Did another fall down?
Yeah.
That hits that chimney or they get down too.
You ain't gonna get the hell out of here.
He said that one of the guys up on top.
I said it.
Hey, Joe, stand on the inside. Where
is that? Okay, watch those guys scurry out of the way so they don't get hit by that log. Look out, there they go, sir. Boom. I wouldn't know whether they went through the first floor or not. Here comes that big one that pulled the whole side down. I guess they're going to bring it out of there. Yeah, they're going to... rehook or something. There's that big sucker. Going to the wagon. Gosh. The beam off the ceiling joists for the bottom. Camera side. Being taken up so they can get the joists out and start tearing down the first floor. About 3 o'clock in the afternoon. First floor should come down in a hurry because after they get that one or two of those long logs across the top there, then there's just a matter of getting the shorter logs taken down. So it'll ought to really go down fast when they get to working on that. First floor ceiling joist coming out. Now we'll have about 8 or 10 of those to take out, and then we'll start tearing down the bottom part. They'll be taking 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 rafters out, and there's about 2 down inside they'll have to take out. And the last 2 big ones. Can't seem to lift this one. Picking the old truck right up. Can't see that, but can't budge that for some reason or other. Thank you. I missed the explosion when he got the, finally got that loose. That was some kind of a... One down from the south wall. Big logs that come off. It's all manpower. We haven't used it in 2 or 3 years, but I don't think he would be interested in selling it. I could ask him.
It's fiberglass, isn't it?
I think it is, yeah. That wall could have come right over on him, couldn't it?
Yep.
Big log off, the rest they'll tear down by hand, they say. Working all day yesterday, this is the remains of the logs that they have to work on. I gave it this shot in two segments. Second segment over to the back of the house. Note the, I guess it's gas lines that were put through those logs. logs on the ground that they have to come back and pick up and take over. The rafters they took out first and then just piled them here in a pile. Note that on some of these, they still have the bark on them. All hewed by hand. These are the sims that are placed between the logs, and then in the old days, mud applied to that to seal off the outside. They'll be saving all of these to use in the reconstruction of the house. And we have an invitation to go over and see the house when it's back on it. What's a shame is that all this old lumber, for example, the 3x6s and 2x4s, which are full size, not planed, it'll just probably be burned up. What's left of the back wall, shown in another view, and then all that's left on the front is the chimney with a few heavy planks on the outside of it, no logs. The last stage is got down to the cherry floor on the first floor.
Is that all you lack?
Yeah. Moving on out. This way to move a floor out so you can get to it. Bring it on out of there, Jim.
You can run the back of the
lift up. Yeah, that's what I thought earlier, but I guess everybody has their own way to do things.
Yeah, he knows more
than I do. I agree with you. It looks like we'd be damaging that floor with that. With those teeth on there, but that out of there, it really wreaked havoc on the rest of it, won't it?
Yeah.
Joe's going for a ride, taking it easy. Well, it's hook up time to get the trailer out of here. About 11 o'clock. On the 27th.
Yeah.
Big Dixon truck hooking up, getting ready to take that trailer out of there. Here we go, out comes the trailer. Moving right on out, no problem. Going somewhere, if I can find it. Yeah, there it is. Oh, starting to burn down now. We're going to put that blaze out for some reason. deal is. Besides, that other house is going to burn too fast. Now they're going to get ready to set a fire in the cottage, oxygen mask, et cetera, et cetera. It appears they're wetting down the inside of the cottage now because they took the fire hose in. I see no fire started yet. Going inside the building with the oxygen masks and so on.
We have smoke.
I guess they set the fire in that one room where they have the beam up against the window to keep the air, keep it from coming out those windows. More smoke coming out on the roof. Brave souls carrying more burnable stuff to start the fire. There comes one coming out. They're getting up there now. A lot of smoke. Fortunately, it's blowing to the west right now. Thank goodness for that. Man, that thing goes up in a hurry. Should see some flames here in a minute, I think. Yeah, there's some. Inside right there, I saw some flames. I'll be breaking through the roof most any time now. Thank goodness that wind's blowing to the west right now. There's a lot of smoke coming out of that one hole right there. I don't know if we're going to get any flame or not. Playing a few games now, trying to wet the spectators down with their hose shooting out the window. They set their second fire inside now. Haven't seen any flames outside yet. Thank goodness again, the wind's blowing from the east to the west. I guess that's what you call a controlled burn, is it?
That remains to be seen.
they had a fire at a fire call to the hospital a few minutes ago. One of the trucks had to go up there. Uh-oh, that guy's hot. He came out of there hot, didn't he?
Yep, had something in his jacket.
Yeah. You get a little ember down your neck, you do get warm in a hurry. Interesting to see no flames on the outside yet, do you?
I tell you, it's putting the smoke out.
Yeah, there it goes. There it breaks through. They had that window covered up there. There's guys inside there controlling that fire, Mark. They got a hose running inside and oxygen mask and all that stuff. Hey. Would burn up that column in a hurry. You see there that white right on the corner of the big house?
Yeah.
The charred place below it?
Yeah.
It was up there before they could turn around. They went in there and put the foot of that out. Then went over and started on the cottage.
I'm looks like they're putting the cottage out for it. Started good, didn't it?
Well, I guess that's what they call a controlled burn, honey.
Oh, okay. That would make sense, I guess.
More smoke coming out the roof. Still no, except for that one flash up, no evidence of flames. First flames I see up on the roof. There goes the roof now. It's getting exciting now, isn't it, Becky?
Yep. What's
that raining?
Any idea?
I don't know.
I thought we'd be walking around in there if I could.
Yeah, looks like we're getting a little more action on the outside now. Oh, there it breaks through.
Yes.
Thank you. hear you.
Huh?
I can hear you.
Yeah.
That's your name.
Don't touch the camera.
I hear it popping.
It's just popping and popping, isn't it? You see the hair? Where are you going? See them squirting water off the truck over there?
Rock didn't say something to him about protecting the tree.
What's going to be when that, see that part, this corner up there on the big house is unstable too.
What?
Where are we going, John? Getting too warm?
Nah, he isn't another one.
The doggone trees blocking off when the big house goes down.
Yeah. It really isn't a good unless you move over the fence, and I think that's too close to too much.
Down there, maybe.
What's there?
Come back here. Come on, honey. Came down, didn't it? Well, the place that caught is a really up there. Well, it's going to go here in a minute, isn't it?
Yep.
Better be a week before the ice is cool enough for them to get in there and do it.
Yeah.
car. Going faster and faster, right? Hitting that tree pretty good. It's got some of the leaves, you see that barn?
I'm just thinking something in that ash tree and one branch in that elm.
An excavator. I told John Perry he won any land level, just rent the dog out to him.
That is up today.
They got the big house fire control pretty good. Clara. Back here.
Not camera.
Come on. Please.
Come on now, or you're going in now.
To the bathroom.
Yeah.
Look at that. God.
That little dark smoke is not necessarily
It's old. It's got to burn over. Get a fire burning real hot. It'll put out the light.
Oh, yeah. Oh Lord, they lost water power.
Thank you, Johnny.
Video came around through. Get a shot from the sun. And the sun
could look across
the fire.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. You just got it. I got to kill you. There we go. Yeah, I'm going back out there. You got
to kill you. Mark, you're going to be. You must be going. You've been picked up.
A sign popped up there in front of the house where the big tower of the bridge was not responsible for the fire past the
rain.
And we'll have to
find
it back.
Yeah,
it's clear, Bob.
He's over here.
Throw it, Claire.
That water pressure is enough to knock that parts down. Yeah. Clara, Clara, Clara.
Honey,
did enough water pressure to knock those pieces over?
You have a visitor. Come on, around here to your mom. Come on. Yeah, you just had to get on camera, didn't you? Throw me, she's digging it out into the grass. Are they hosing down the truck back there? No, it can't be because there's people right close there.
Thank you.
I
truck. Oh, that's got yeah.
You're on camera. You're on camera.
That big house has to be ready to collapse.
Pretty close. Shouldn't
be a whole lot in there holding it up. No. I forgot to put the date on it. Battery's holding up anyway.
Yeah, if it's a good battery, you should be able to get like 2 hours, 3 hours. Chimney may be helping hold up the big house too.
Yeah. Yeah.
Although it kind of looks like a chimney may be leaning and lifting to the porch side.
Thank goodness the wind was from the east and from the northwest. When Dean burns out there, that stuff comes right in.
Yeah, I mean, normally the wind
there goes, and there goes. Dropped some of them down anyway.
Clara, Clara, don't throw it. It kind of makes you wonder how fire departments get any fires out for the houses burned down.
Yeah. Look, there it goes. Car falling to the front.
Okay.
He turned that pressure hose on him.
Cooled off the car.
Yeah. Bobby, hand me a here, please.
Off after the bug and forgot he was on the chain. That chain jerked him flat on top of his head. No, that didn't have anything to do with it. He was chasing a bug. And he got to the end of the cable and it jerked him back and he landed on his head.
Thank you.
Hey, Gene? Gene?
Yeah?
They're trying to knock the chimney down.
Deep hole down to some water down the bottom of this well underneath the pump. Bear peak down there. Coming up out of the pump.
Well, that's a shame, but the heat from the fire broke the big rock over the well. There goes the big well going to be filled. In a cloud of smoke, would you believe? Fire in the hole.
Hi, they're splitting apart so I can do a close-up on you. So smile. Don't you hate these things? I always swore I'd never do this.
Well, I heard George Carlin being interviewed the other night, and he says he doesn't understand video. All these video cameras, everybody videotapes it.
That secret sauce?
Yeah, secret sauce. Only problem is that I didn't get...
Because I would try and he would get upset with me and I'd get upset because I couldn't do it left-handed. So anyway, she taught him to tie shoes. There, stop, please.
How many copies do we have?